Young ladies, if you'll listen, a sad story I'll relate. It happened in Fort Thomas in the old Kentucky state. 'Twas January the 31st, this dreadful deed was done. By Jackson and by Walling, how cold their blood did run. Little did Pearl Bryan think when she left her home that day, the grip she carried in her hand would hide her head away. She thought it was her lover's hand she could trust both night and day, although it was her lover's hand that took her life away. Little did Pearl Bryan's parents think when she left her home that day, this darling girl just in her youth would never more return. How sad it would have been to them to have heard Pearl's lonely voice at midnight in that lonely spot where those two boys rejoiced. The driver in the seat is all who knows of Pearl's sad fate. A poor Pearl Bryan away from home in the old Kentucky state. Of her aged parents we all know well what fortune they would give if Pearl was but to them returned her natural life to live. In came Pearl Bryan's sister, fallen on her knees, pleading to Scott Jackson, "Oh, my sister's head, oh, please." Scott Jackson said, "A stubborn jaw, not a word would he have said. I'll meet my sister in heaven, where they'll find her missing head. Now, young ladies, all take warning. Men are so unjust. It may be your best lover, but you know not whom to trust. Pearl Bryan died away from home upon a lonely spot. Take heed, believe me, girls. Don't let this be your lot."